that is powerful.
Hey guys, I finally got this bow. This is the heaviest crab bow that I have, based off of Mughal crab bows. In fact, if you look commercially, most crab bows are under 50 pounds, and really the only ones that, you know, are above 100 pounds is horn sinew ones.
So the bow I'm shooting today is based on a historical bow design seen in the Mughal Empire, which was an empire during the 16th to 19th century. The greatest extent of this empire includes parts of modern-day India / Afghanistan / Bangladesh. So the Mughal crab bow is also known as a command. By the way, the Mughals didn't just use this specific bow design. They had various other ones such as self bows, but the bow I have today is based on the command design, but made of fiberglass. So back to the historical Mughal crab bows. They had a very extreme recurve design, and to make such bows, it requires high craftsmanship and skills in composite bowmaking. Unlike typical Ottoman Turkish bows, the limbs of the crab bow are usually wider to reduce twists, and it allows the bow to be left strong for longer periods of time. If you look at the Sias, it is very stiff and non-flexible, forcing the entire bend in such a tiny portion of the limbs alone. This is why it is very challenging to make this bow in fiberglass, and it shows the superiority of organic horn sinew composite materials in elasticity. But my boyer Toto Alharis nonetheless attempted it with fiberglass. The end result is a bow that can only be pulled to 26 inches according to the boyer. But you know, I've seen successful crab bows made of fiberglass that's 50 pounds and can be pulled to 28 inches, but nothing of this draw weight. So like, I think this is the first one that's, you know, above 100 pounds that's made of fiberglass.
Here's my thumb, very high brace height, very compact. And how is the Sias? They're lining up straight. Good. Oh, this thing is heavy. 26 is the max draw length, by the way. I can't pull further than 26. Wow, it's fast. You can feel it. It's a fast bow. So like what the boyer said, do not pull beyond 26 inches. That is the max that he tried to pull with such a short bow and such an extreme bend. Look at the bending on this fiberglass. You really don't want to take that risk. So like I said, I only try to pull a 25, maybe 26, but I don't want to exceed 26. I'll do 25 if I can, because I don't want to break this thing. It's such a heavy bow too, you know? It has a very high initial draw weight. Like already it feels like 90 pounds. And from this draw length to here, it's the draw length doesn't really increase, it just bends. So the initial draw weight is already so high. It's like a mini Manchu in that sense. Very high force draw curve. That's as far as it can pull without using my back. So to pull this thing, it's very different compared to the Hungarian bow that I had. That force draw curve was so linear. In the beginning with the Hungarian bow, it's pretty light. Like you were talking 40 pounds, but then it gets to, you know, 100 something in the last few inches. This thing, it's already that draw weight in the beginning. That's crazy. The original crab bows are meant to be drawn short. So this thing is almost there. It has that 1 or 2 inch, it's missing that last 2 inches. Could I pull that? Well, the boyer said don't pull this beyond 26, so I don't want to try. Most likely, it's going to break. If he says don't pull 26, I think there's a pretty good reason, because you can already see how much bending this fiberglass is doing. These are not horn sinew bows, they're less elastic. So I don't want this thing exploding in my face if I pull beyond 26. And that's why I wear safety glasses. This thing is a very extreme design. With my Hungarian fiberglass, I'm very confident with it. It's not gonna break spectacularly. This thing has so much stress on the limbs here. And even though it has such a short draw length, it's still very fast because these limbs are being used to the max potential here. So there's a lot of efficiency that you're getting from this. Oh, wow, that is powerful.